Ano ang Jubilee year? Let me tell you. Ano ang dapat kong gawin para makakuha ang Jubilee
year? Ano ang Jubilee year? Ano ang plenary indulgence? Ano ang dapat kong gawin para makakuha? Ang Jubilee year o Holy Year wang every 25 and 50 year. Before, ang San Isidro 25th year anniversary bilang isang parokya ni Jaime Cardinal Sin noong March 20. Marami nang nangyari sa loob ng 25 years. Kaya nga ang tema ng ating Jubilee Year Celebration ay SILP at 25, Daluyan ng Pangangalaga, Paglago at Pagbabahagi. Isang biyaya ngayong Jubilee Year ay ang tinatawag na Plenary Indulgence. Ano nga ba ang Plenary Indulgence? Ayon sa Catechism of the Catholic Church, indulgence is a remission before God of the temporal punishment due to sin whose guilt has already been forgiven. Kapag tayo ay nangumpisal, pinapatawad ng Diyos ang ating mga kasalanan. Pero meron pa ring epekto ng kasalanan na nananatili sa atin. Yun ang temporal punishment. At ang indulhensya ang nag-aalis ng temporal punishment. May dalawang uri ang indulhensya. Plenary indulgence, inaalis lahat ng ating temporal punishment, at partial indulgence, inaalis ang bahagi ng ating temporal punishment. Ibig sabihin, dahil sa indulhensyang ito na ipinagkaloob sa atin ng inang simbahan sa Roma, bukas ang pintuan ng langit. Lahat ng bibisita at dadaan sa Jubilee Door ng ating parokya ay maaaring makatanggap ng plenary indulgence
simula May 15, 2024 hanggang May 14, 2025.
Ano ang dapat kong gawin para makamit ang plenary indulgence? Here are the conditions for plenary indulgence. Una, enter the Holy Door or Porta Sancta of San Isidro Labrador Parish. Pangalawa, resolve to avoid committing sins at tumanggap ng sakramento ng kumpisal. Pangatlo, receive Holy Communion at Mass, ipagdasal ang Santo Papa at ang kanyang intensyon. At panghuli,
conclude the prayer with Our Father, Apostles' Creed, panalangin sa Mahal na Ina at panalangin kay San Isidro Labrador.
Nawa, sa tulong ng panalangin ng ating patron San Isidro Labrador, maging makabuluhan ang pagdiriwang natin ng Jubilee Year. Mas mapalapit tayo sa Panginoon, tularan natin ang mga mabubuting gawain ni San Isidro Labrador.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Before we begin the Mass, we wish to remind everyone to focus on the celebration. May we request that off. As a reminder to everyone, please take good care of your personal belongings. Do not leave them unattended. Please do not leave your trash inside our church. Parents are likewise reminded to look after their children and not let them play or loiter around while Mass is going on. For an orderly distribution of communion, this will be done by rows. We continue to remind everyone to wear the proper attire in attending the Mass. You can see on the tarpaulin near the entrance the proper dress code for the Holy Mass. The following couple intends to receive the sacrament of matrimony: Christina May Araya and Francisco M. Jaena. Please check our bulletin board located outside our church if you know of any impediments. Thank you. During the Eucharistic celebration, we invite everyone to actively participate by joining in the singing and reciting the responses flashed on the screen. Please all rise, and we will now begin the Eucharistic celebration.
My dear brothers and sisters, we begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, we have lots of fears and worries in life, but Jesus is inviting us to trust in Him, for He knows everything. We now remember our sins, and we ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Together we say, I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. And may Almighty God of mercy on us forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest. We bless you, we adore you, 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 we bless you Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb, when I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands, when I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no further, and here shall your proud waves be stilled.'" The word of the Lord. They who sailed the sea in ships, trading on the deep waters, these saw the works of the Lord and his wonders in the abyss. His command raised up a storm wind, which tossed its waves on high. They mounted up to heaven, they sank on the depths, their hearts melted away in their plight. They cried to the Lord in their distress. From their straits he rescued them. He hushed the storm to a gentle breeze, and the billows of the sea were stilled. They rejoiced that they were calmed, and he brought them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his kindness and his wondrous deeds to the children of men.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who, for their sake, died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord. A great prophet has risen in our midst. God has visited his people.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark. On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was a great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even wind and sea obey?" My brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat, mga kapatid. Hindi ko alam kung nakaranas na kayong sumakay sa bangka o sa barko na napakalakas ng alon. Malayo pa lang, mas malaki pa siya sa bangka o sa barko na sinasakyan natin. At talaga naman sa nakaranas, ay nakakatakot talaga, no? At halos mawala yung kaluluwa mo. At sa ebanghelyo ay siguro mas nakakatakot talaga, no? May bagyo, malaki ang alon, para matakot ang mga isda. Talagang nakakatakot talaga siguro, no? Kasi sanay sila, no? Sa dagat, pero sa pagkakataon nito, natakot ba naman sila at ginising ang Panginoon, no? Kaya siguro napakalaking pangyayaring ito na parang hindi nila alam ang gagawin kahit nasanay sila sa lugar na yon. At ano ang sinasabi nito sa ating buhay ngayon, no? Sa ating pagninilay sa linggong ito? Number one, trust in Jesus during life's storms, no? Magtiwala kay Jesus, manampalataya sa Jesus sa gitna ng bagyo ng buhay. In the Gospel today, we encounter Jesus and his disciples crossing the Sea of Galilee when a violent storm arises. The disciples are terrified and wake Jesus, pleading, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" Jesus stands up, rebukes the wind, and commands the sea to be still, resulting in a profound calm. This narrative invites us to reflect on our own lives, the storms we face, life's storms, whether they are personal crises, health issues, financial problems, or emotional struggles, can fill us with fear and doubt. This passage teaches us to place our trust in Jesus, knowing that He is always with us, even when it seems He is asleep. Kaya nga kapag nakaranas tayo ng matinding unos, sinasabi natin, no, sa ating buhay, di ba parang yung mga apostoles, nakakapagtanong din tayo, Panginoon, bakit parang tulog ka yata? Hindi mo nararamdaman, hindi mo nakita ang aming sitwasyon, natutulog ka ba? Panginoon, para bang nalimutan mo na ba kami? No? Kapag dumating sa buhay natin, no? Yung nakaraan man yon, yung ngayon mismo na nararanasan natin, siguro may mga dinadala tayo, mga takot, no? Mga bagyo ngayon na naranasan natin sa buhay, yung mga darating pa. No? Ito palagi nasasabi naman talaga natin, no? Na para bang naiwan tayo ng Panginoon, nalilimutan tayo ng Panginoon. Just as He calmed the storm for the disciples, He has the power to bring peace and resolution to the chaotic situations we encounter. So this point encourages us to deepen our faith and trust in Jesus' ability to calm the storms in our lives, no? Reminding us that we are never alone. No? Yung mapaalaala sa atin ngayon, na sa gitna ng maunos sa ating buhay, mga takot sa ating buhay, mga alalahanin sa ating buhay, yung marinig natin ulit, kahit alam natin, pero minsan kailangan sabihin pa ulit sa atin. No? At ito yung sinasabi ng Ebanghelyo ngayon. No? Huwag tayong matakot. Ang Panginoon ay kasama natin. Ang Panginoon, alam niya ang sitwasyon natin. Ang Panginoon ay handang tumulong sa atin. Second, yung tinatawag natin, the presence of fear and the call to faith. Ang pagkakaroon ng takot at ang tawag ng pananampalataya. The disciples' reaction to the storm, fear and panic, contrasts sharply with Jesus' calm and authoritative response. Tataka sila, no? Bakit ang Panginoon natutulog? Parang relax na relax tayo. Yung kaba natin, yung takot natin, grabe na. Hindi at nandun lang Panginoon, no? After calming the storm, Jesus asked them, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" This question challenges us to examine our own reactions to fear and adversity. Fear is a natural human response, but Jesus calls us to transcend our fear through faith. No, hindi nawawala yung takot. Natural yon na nararamdaman ng isang tao. Pero yung hinihiling sa atin ay pumangibabaw sa takot na yon. Nandyan siya, pero mas malalim ang tiwala natin sa Diyos, pananampalataya. In moments of fear and uncertainty, we are invited to lean on our faith and trust in Jesus. This passage reminds us that faith is not the absence of fear, but the presence of trust in the midst of fear. It invites us to move beyond our immediate reactions and to place our confidence in Jesus' presence and power. By doing so, we can experience His peace and assurance even in the most turbulent times in our lives. Kaya magandang tingnan sa oras na ito, ano ba yung mga takot ko sa buhay? Ano ba yung aking mga alalahanin ngayon sa buhay? Ano ba yung mga iniisip ko palagi na halos hindi na ako makatulog, no? Sa dami ng mga alalahanin ko sa buhay, no? Kahit ako, ang dami-dami kong takot sa buhay, hindi ko alam. At minsan ay, no, na nakakalimot tayo. Nagdududa tayo. Nagdadalawang isip tayo. But again, no, the fear will always be there. But the call for us to have that trust in the presence of God. Hindi alisin ang takot dahil natural itong reaksyon ng tao. Pero ang hiniling sa atin ay ang manampalataya tayo sa presensya ng Diyos. Number three, recognizing Jesus' divine authority, pagkilala sa banal na kapangyarihan o otoridad ng ating Panginoong Jesus. The disciples' amazement at the calming of the storm leads them to ask, "Who is this?" Sino ba ito? Sabi nila, no? Even the wind and the waves obey him. This reaction underscores the recognition of Jesus' divine authority. He is not merely a teacher or a prophet. He is the Son of God, possessing power over all creation. Hindi lamang sa Diyos na palagi tayong humihingi. Hindi lamang sa Diyos na palagi tayong tumatawag. Pero nais din natin, nais din ng Panginoon na mas kilalanin natin siya. No? Maliban doon sa mga paghingi natin, maliban doon sa paglapit natin, kung anumang tulong gusto natin, mas mainam at makita natin na mas kilalanin natin siya. Sino ba siya sa ating buhay? Maliban sa pagtulong sa ating palagi, sino ba ang Panginoong Jesus? This realization calls us to a deeper acknowledgement of Jesus' divine power and His rightful place in our lives. It invites us to worship Him with awe and reverence, recognizing that He is Lord over all creation and our personal Savior. No, kaya nawa sa pagsimba natin, tuwing Linggo, ang iba sa atin araw-araw, sa mga pagrorosaryo natin, sa mga debosyon natin, sa mga panalangin natin sa bahay, sa kung saan man tayo, pagpunta natin sa Adoration Chapel, no, sana mas lalo pang lumalim ang pagkilala natin sa Panginoon. Mas lalo pa nawang lumalim ang relasyon natin sa Diyos. This passage challenges us to re-evaluate and understand in our understanding of who Jesus is and to respond with a renewed sense of awe and devotion. It reminds us that Jesus is sovereign over every aspect of our lives and the world, and that His authority extends beyond our understanding. Kaya mga kapatid, sa linggong ito, sa Ebanghelyo na narinig natin ngayon, sana ay mas lalo pang lumalim, no, ang ating pananampalataya sa Panginoon. Trust in Jesus during life's storms. Number two, the presence of fear and the call of faith. Ano man ang takot, pangamba, pag-aalala, nandyan yan. Pero sana malampasan natin ito dahil sa pananampalataya. And lastly, recognizing Jesus' divine authority. Sana mas lumalim pa ang pagkilala natin sa Panginoon, mas lumawak pa ang influensya niya sa ating buhay, at maging salamin tayo sa ating kapwa ng kaniyang presensya. Amen. We now profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. All things visible. Let us pray to God, our Father, that with His power we may weather the storms of life. Let our response be, Lord, save your people.
For the church, the boat of Peter, that it may not lose heart when the storms of persecution and dissension threaten to sink it, we pray. For our government and civil leaders, that they may spare no effort to bring peace to places where rebellion and armed conflict are destroying lives and homes, we pray. That political and civil leaders may desist from going after instant popularity and political windfalls, but pursue what is truly beneficial for the people, we pray. That families beset by continual fighting and for homes threatened by the surging waves of unemployment and poverty, that they may find in Jesus the will to weather these storms, we pray. For our beloved dead, that the Lord may lead them safely home to heaven and fulfill their faith and hope, we pray. Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Father, amid the various storms of life, let us again hear the voice of your Son Jesus, quiet, be still. May we find peace in our hearts and in one another. We ask this through Christ our Lord. My dear friends, pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world, and you have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image, and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the mystery, the memorial of his death, resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jesse, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. And now at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Lord Jesus Christ said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." My dear friends, we offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Sa gitna ng mga maraming takot, pangamba at mga alalahanin natin sa buhay, naway mangibabaw ang ating pananampalataya dahil nandyan ang Diyos kasama natin. My dear friends, this is Jesus, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to His supper. Lord,
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate in constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Please be seated for some announcements. The parish has opened the holy door for its Jubilee year. We invite everyone to enter this holy door and gain plenary indulgence until May 14, 2025. The parish's commission and family is inviting everyone to their Ugnayan Fellowship on June 26, Wednesday at 7 in the evening. The Diocese of Parañaque will hold virtual classes on basic faith formation to those interested, especially those who wish to be catechists. This will be every Saturday from July 13 until December 7, 2024, from 2 to 4 in the afternoon. The parish will hold a bloodletting program on July 14 from 8 in the morning until 1 in the afternoon. Donate blood and help save lives. Please all stand.
Sa inyo pong lahat na narito at sa mga nag-serve sa misa, thank you po na sa inyo. And the Lord be with you. Kindly bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Bestow pardon and peace, O Lord, we pray, upon your faithful, that they may be cleansed from every offense and serve you with untroubled hearts, through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Mass has been offered. We now go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Heart, one voice, one soul, one family, all hearts are beating with Jesus Christ so dear. One heart, one voice.